Today's words of wisdom, breatharianism, and the eating habit will be presented in English and Spanish with subtitles in Arabic, Alsace or Vietnamese, Chinese, Dutch, English, French, German, Hebrew, Hindi, Hungarian, Indonesian, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Mongolian, Persian, Polish, Portuguese, Punjabi, Romanian, Russian, Spanish, Thai, Turkish, and Urdu. More languages are available online. For your special language, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/subtitles. In late 2010, at the invitation of Mexico's Secretariat of Environment and Natural Resources, Supreme Master Ching Hai arrived in Cancun, Mexico, to offer her support through prayers as well as her gentle presence for the United Nations Climate Change Conference, or COP16, and its crucial mission of forging an international treaty to curb global warming and protect the world's citizens. During the course of the Climate Change Summit, some of the attending dignitaries who had the chance to speak with Supreme Master Ching Hai included the President of Mexico, His Excellency Felipe Calderon, Moldovan Minister of Environment and Natural Resources, Jorge Salaru, Togo's national focal point to the UNFCC, Ambassador Komi Tomyeba, Head of the Climate Change Department at the Egyptian Environmental Affairs Agency, Dr. Azet Louis Hanela Ajibi, Ugandan Environment Minister, Her Excellency Jessica Erio, and Peru's Environment Minister, Dr. Antonio Jose Brack Egg. Furthermore, while in Cancun, Supreme Master Ching Hai granted a number of interviews to print, radio, and television representatives of the Mexican media. She was also invited as the guest of honor for the Greenest Heroes Gala, co-hosted by the Mayor of Cancun, the Honorable Jaime Hernandez Zaragoza, and the Supreme Master Ching Hai International Association, the charity campaign by Cancun's Lady Mayoress and President of the Social Welfare Agency for the city's Benito Juarez Borough, Patty Menendez de Hernandez, as well as a press conference with members of the media. Following Supreme Master Ching Hai's example of true love in action, our association members from over 10 countries arrived in Cancun to distribute leaflets and promote the organic vegan diet as the single most effective solution to climate change. Despite her busy schedule, Supreme Master Ching Hai often met with our association members to answer questions and shared her wisdom. We now invite you to join us for Supreme Master Ching Hai's discussion with our association members entitled Breatharianism and the Eating Habit, given in Cancun, Mexico, on December 18th and 19th, 2010.
Supreme Master Ching Hai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For free of charge guidance, please visit www.godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
This program discusses the possibility of breatharianism, or living without eating food, and is not a full instruction. For your safety, please do not attempt to cease eating without proper expert guidance.
It was very cute and strange, but a lot of people is already vegetarian.
Yes.
And when they see we're handing out vegetarian information, they are so happy. Even it was a family, like they came and she told me like they are all vegetarians before boarding.
Yeah.
Like all three generations or something like that, all vegetarian.
Mm.
And a lot of kids just went to grab some of the recipe books and then came back with their mothers.
Mm.
And they were, Mommy, Mommy, this is vegan. We are vegan. We need this.
Oh. Yeah. So nice. Yes, yes, yes,
yes. Yes,
yes. You'll be surprised, huh?
Yes.
Meeting people like that, huh? It's a happy thing. Yeah. Like this, they go home and think, oh, maybe we should do the same, you know, and then maybe they print some leaflet and give to their neighbors or something. Maybe they didn't think like that before, but now they do, eh? Yeah, okay.
Oh, well, I don't know if it's another good story or not, mm-hmm. but there was a guy that he was on meat industry. He's, how do you say that when they have...
Meat industry?
Yeah.
Slaughterhouse or yes, selling meat?
Selling meat. He's the one who has the slaughterhouse.
Oh my God.
So he told me, you know, that the big pollution came from fossil fuels and such things. Uh-huh. But after we talk a little more with
he
him.
He understood?
Well, he says he will think about it. Uh-huh. He said he will think about it. And he took your information.
Mm, at least he think about it. Maybe yes. he did not know.
But his partner, I think mm-hmm. it was his wife, she told him, you see, I told you already. Mm-hmm. This is all true. I told mm-hmm. you already. Mm-hmm. So maybe we don't know.
Okay, okay. It's good. Good idea. Good idea that she told him. Yeah, yeah. Many people who own meat industry-related businesses, sometimes they don't know. Yeah? Just busy working, earning money like everybody else, you know, it's like a business. And when you open a business, there are a lot of things to do, yeah, all the time. So they don't even go thinking in that direction, you know? Mm. Truly like that. And these people, if they don't know and they repent, then they can be saved. Yes.
Okay.
If not, then too bad, really, this time, last time. Mm. Good story. How come only good? You're the only one who has good story.
I don't know. I think it's the only one I understand English.
You mean Spanish?
I mean yes, yeah, Spanish and English.
Ah, okay. Really, she understands also.
Oh,
yeah. And she also speaks English, no? Your mama to hablo English, no? She? Nada. Poquito. Any other male don't have story ever? Always hear from woman. No. Did she tell you some good story to tell me?
Master, the day before yesterday, we went to the police station, municipality, and we visit the auxiliary police. They have many divisions, but this was like very important here in Cancun, and by the way, it was a party, a posada. It's a Mexican traditional party.
Party.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
And there was the mayor.
The mayor is there.
The mayor was there.
Of Cancun.
Of Cancun.
Oh, you told us about that. One of the.
Yes, one sister from Canada.
Okay. Told
you.
Yeah.
I don't know if she told you because I was buying chocolates.
Uh-huh.
That the mayor says, oh, please, thanks a lot, Supreme Master Chinghai. She blesses us very much since she is in Cancun. Mm-hmm. And please tell her to say hello and thanks from my wife, very especially from my wife. And there was important people and media as well.
Yeah.
Three different groups.
Yeah.
They took us pictures and video for TV and interviewed me.
Mm-hmm.
I spoke about global warming and of course.
So you saved the planet, huh?
Of course, I said we beige go green to save the planet and the solution and so on. People was very, very kind with us and also the secretary.
Of the mayor?
Yes, I think. And security, el secretario de seguridad pública, secretary of public security as well. Very, very kind.
Oh.
And the chief of auxiliary police, she lead us to the mayor. And
to the mayor of Cancun?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And hold us very often and told us, you are very, very welcome. And all those high people give us cards and the mayor write his mail and private phone. We have it and says, please, anything you need, just call us.
Oh, wow. What a good man.
They really, really appreciate your work and love you very, very much.
I love the mayor, too.
Yes.
I love people here anyway. I think they're all very nice. Yes. I didn't meet all of them, but whom I meet is very nice.
Our sister from Canada, she asked, oh, how about here in Cancun work to became the first city
vegan city in the world. Wow.
Yes, and he said, I'm working on that. Mm-hmm. I'll try.
I heard that. Yeah. Well, if we could, eh? One city at a time, huh? If Cancun became, maybe everybody, you know, copy, huh?
Yes.
Yeah. So maybe we just work on Cancun, eh? Yeah. If we can stay, it's good. We cannot. Eh? Whatever. But they're very, very good already. We come in and stay 6 months, you know? Just like that. It's so convenient already. Yeah. Very good.
European Parliament supports reducing meat to lower greenhouse gases.
Roll call vote. Vote is now open.
Reduce your meat consumption or stop eating meat totally.
During discussions on greenhouse gas reduction goals, the Climate Committee of the European Parliament officially recognized livestock's contribution to global warming and recommended a reduction of subsidies to the livestock industry to curb methane.
The European Parliament has adopted its own position on climate change as an institution. And as a vice president, one of the proposals I've made is in line with your own, which is that we should eat far less meat, because that's one of the major sources of greenhouse gases.
We know that the agriculture and the meat production is one of the main causes of gas emission. And so it's very clear that the ratio per habitant of meat has to decrease.
My name is Jens Holm. I'm a member of the European Parliament. Please, be veg, go green, save the planet.
It's just because of COP16, or it will be always like this? I think to have a retired position and stay here, it's not that difficult if you have the money every month or somebody guarantee, you know.
Pero creo que tener esa posición de retirado no es nada difícil aquí o si alguien te lo garantiza.
Okay. So some young people here can retire already. Yeah, you don't have to even open a bank account here. You just show that you have other bank. And your bank say to them that you have a lot of money in there, then you're okay also. It's very easy. I read the regulation. Yeah, yeah, it's not bad. But in Mexico, it's already easy, no? Yeah, it's cool. But that's smart, you know? So instead of they retire in their country, they can come to retire in this country. And the government also is good for the government, I mean the country also. Because if the person stay here, that means he rent house or he buy houses and then he buy food and all kind of spending here instead, you see?
Yes.
It's a very smart country. And I don't know why people don't come and live here.
Yeah.
Yeah. For ordinary people, it's so easy to come and live here. Huh? They have sea, yeah?
Yes.
They have fruit. Have nice people. The living here is cheaper, no?
Yes.
Right? Or not?
Yes, and the health system is also very good. It's very, very good health system at very, very small price.
Mm. I heard something like even if you're a tourist, you can also profit from the health system here even. Yeah. If you're sick, they also don't take money from you or something like that. Or is it somewhere else? I forgot. Yeah, in Spain it's like that. You don't have to be Spanish to be admitted and treated in the hospital. They don't take your money or nothing. It was difficult to pay in Spain. They just don't take it. One time, you know, I had a little trouble with the eye. And we would see doctor and it's just difficult to pay, you know. It's just very difficult to pay. Yeah, okay.
Le agradezco mucho que nos haya invitado a cenar. La pasé muy bien, me encanta. Cuando nos juntamos todos y cenamos juntos. Y me preocupa cuando seamos respiracionistas, ¿cómo vamos a tener esos eventos tan hermosos? ¿Cómo nos vamos a reunir si ya no vamos a tener que comer?
Tell me.
Thank you, Master. I really appreciate you that you invited us.
Right?
Yes, you invited us for dinner. It was such a beautiful time. We had a really, really beautiful time.
Today?
Yes, today. And we enjoyed very much. So I'm very worried when we became Breatharians. We are not having these beautiful occasions to gather.
Why not?
¿Por qué no?
We have different time, different. We sit, meditate.
Es una ocasión diferente. Nos sentaremos a meditar.
Yeah, but not all are suitable for breatharian, eh? Unless you meditate very well, eh? Yes, and overcome your destiny.
Pero no todos son aptos para ser respiracionistas, a menos que mediten muy bien y se sobrepongan a su destino.
Some people try, but they cannot go on. Their body will not let because of destiny, because of karma. Yeah?
Algunas personas tratan, pero no van a ser capaces porque no se pueden sobreponer a su destino ni a su karma.
You should worry when you become breatharian. You're not yet, so why worry?
Deberías de preocuparte hasta que te hicieras respiracionista y todavía no, entonces ¿para qué te preocupas?
Yeah. Just like you don't have money and worry about the thieves or the robbers.
Es como cuando no tienes dinero y te preocupas que te roben o que te salten.
What happened if I'm going to be rich?
¿Qué pasaría si es que soy rica?
Death, huh? Really unnecessary, huh?
Es realmente innecesario que te preocupes.
Instead of breatharian, maybe you go slow first. Maybe eat like twice a day, less, or once a day, you know, slowly, and then see how it goes. Or just once a day, like the Buddha, you know, the middle way. Not breatharian, but not glutenian. Gluten, yeah? Glutenian, I call it. Eat too much.
Quizás no tengas que hacerte respiracionista, sino puedas comer dos veces al día o una vez al día. El punto medio, como el Buda, por ejemplo, no ser ni respiracionista ni tampoco ser glotonista.
The thing is, the reason why we eat too much because the cook and leave it there. See what I mean? And everybody jump on the food and eat together and it seems fun and then we just keep eating because we like the fun of it also, yeah? The warm of family gathering and stuff, you know? And then it becomes good memory. See? Good memory you want to repeat again and again and again. Yes. Just like when I'm with you, I eat more than when I normally do, yeah? It's not difficult to eat once or twice a day. If the food is not so readily available and tasty and fun and like that, you know what I mean? Yeah. If you're alone, for example, huh, you don't feel like eating that much. Or if you do, you don't eat that much. And you could even go on the whole day without eating anything and then eat in the evening if you have something more interesting to do. Yeah?
La razón por la que uno come tanto es porque nos gusta el ambiente, nos gusta la diversión y entonces eso luego se nos hace un buen recuerdo. Entonces es por eso que a nosotros nos gusta comer. Incluso yo cuando estoy aquí con ustedes como más porque disfrutamos el ambiente, porque nos gusta estar juntos.
So if you want to be vegetarian, first we have to fire the cooks here because she cooks a lot. She loves to cook.
Así que si ustedes quieren
and
volverse,
we are all the victims here.
Así que si ustedes quieren volverse respiracionistas, primero tenemos que despedir a todas las personas que nos cocinan aquí porque todos nosotros somos víctimas.
Yeah, including myself. Yeah.
Incluyéndome a mí misma.
If you're busy, for example, doing a lot of other interesting thing or meditate a lot the whole day, then you don't feel wanting to eat at all. In the evening, maybe you eat something and that satisfies you the whole day, whole night. In the morning, you don't feel like eating because you have rested very well, your body recovered. Yes. Or meditate in the night, in the morning, never feel hungry, rarely feel hungry. Rarely feel wanting to eat. Actually, it's not hunger, it's just appetite. You know, when we see food, we like to eat, and then once we taste it, like to eat more. That's the problem. Otherwise, if you don't see it much, then you don't really care that much. Or if you meditate very well, you sleep well in the night, don't even care the food until maybe 3, 4, 5 o'clock in the afternoon, when you run down a little bit. See what I mean? Yeah. And when you're bored, you know, like sit all day, you want a break. And food is the only comfort we have. Yeah? See? Because the husband don't care so much anymore now. Job couldn't care less, you know? What else? See what I mean? Yeah.
La razón por la que comemos tanto es porque cuando uno está ocupado, es porque dejan la comida allí. Entonces, cuando uno está ocupado, uno no come tanto. Podemos comer nada más a la mitad del día y quedar satisfechos. Pero cuando uno quiere un descanso, buscamos la comida porque es el único confort que nos queda.
Just like for a break, you know what I mean?
Es solamente para un descanso.
It's kind of comfort.
Como un tipo de comodidad.
Like a comfort zone, eh? The kitchen, comfort zone.
La cocina es como una zona de confort, de comodidad.
So like sometimes you're stressed out, no? And you like to eat a little bit just to comfort, have a break.
Algunas veces estamos estresados y nos gusta comer nada más por un poco de confort, de comodidad,
like
descanso.
That. Yes. But when you're happy and busy, you know, interested in some real meaningful project or work, you hardly feel the time passing.
Pero cuando tú estás contento, estás enfocado en un proyecto, muy poco sentimos correr el tiempo muy poco.
So if you really want to be breatharian, you have to go find somebody to lead you through 21 day process.
Así que si verdaderamente quieres hacerte respiracionista, tienes que encontrar a alguien que te lleve durante un proceso de 3 semanas.
I told you yesterday about the 3 weeks.
Ya les he contado ayer acerca del proceso de las 3 semanas.
I tell you what it is that you have to go through, okay?
Ya les he contado de lo que tienen que atravesar.
Then you pick, ¿no? First week, no eat, no drink. Not even a drop, not even a grain of rice.
La primera semana no come ni bebe nada, ni siquiera una gota, ni siquiera un granito de arroz.
And on the 8th day, second week, you drink diluted fruit juice.
Y en el octavo día, en la segunda semana, comen, toman, beben este jugo diluido.
1/4 of fruit juice, 3/4 water mixed together.
Mezclados juntos, 1/4 de jugo con 3/4 de agua.
You have to drink a little bit first at the time, just a 1 or 2 deciliters. 2-3 spoonful.
Primero tienen que beber un poquito, como 3 o 4 decilitros, como unas cuantas cucharadas.
More.
Y lentamente tomar más.
The third week is more humane.
La tercera semana es más humanitaria.
You can drink like 40% of fruit juice diluted in 60% of water.
Y beben 40% de.
Still no food.
Y beben 40% de jugo y 60% de agua,
after
pero aún sin
that,
comida.
After 3 weeks. If you go through it, you know, and you can eat again if you want.
Y luego de 3 semanas pueden comer otra vez si es que si lo desean.
It's funny, many people want.
Y es gracioso, pero mucha gente quiere.
Yeah. And sometimes you lost a lot of weight.
Y algunas veces pierdes demasiado peso.
You become like a chopstick.
Te vuelves como un palito. Chino.
You don't look hot anymore.
Corazón, ya no estás guapo.
No guapo, hot.
Sexy.
You don't have the word hot in Mexican?
No.
Okay, this is a slang in American anyway. What do you mean hot? How can a person look hot? Like hot dog or something?
Me pregunta, ¿no tienen la traducción a la palabra hot en español?
But,
y le digo
but they
no.
They use it like that, you know, the English slang for. They always say, oh, she looks hot, he looks hot. I feel no heat from that. I don't know why they told me she looks hot and he looks hot.
Dice la maestra, ¿cómo es posible? O sea, dicen que se ve caliente, que se ve caliente, pero yo no siento ningún calor de su parte.
An oven with a glowing fire maybe looks hot, but how the person look like that, how hot? I don't see any fire for me.
Quizás un horno con la flama se vea caliente, pero una persona como él jamás se me haría caliente.
Yeah. It just means sexy, you know? Yeah, very attractive, very seductive, yes.
Pero quiere decir sexy, una persona muy atractiva, muy seductiva.
Okay. No, in case you didn't know what hot and cold mean.
En caso de que no supieran lo que frío y caliente significa.
Yeah. That's what it is, huh? And there are many things you might experience, like headache, dizziness, wobbliness, yeah? Sometimes even fear, depression, but sometimes elated, yeah? Yeah, it changed after a few days, it changed, yes.
Y habrá muchas cosas
Your
que y habrá muchas cosas que ustedes experimentarán, quizás dolores de cabeza, temores, temblores, mareos y algunas veces hasta incluso depresiones, pero algunas otras veces se sentirán elevados.
And if you broke the rule within 7 days, if you drink a little water or you eat a little bit something, you might have trouble, big trouble.
Si rompen la regla los primeros 7 días y toman algo de agua, poquito, o comen algo, estarán en problemas.
Yeah. You might get sickness if you don't do it well, you don't do it correctly, you might be sick, endanger your health, a lot of stuff, or maybe even die.
Si no lo hacen correctamente, dañarán su salud, quizás se enfermen, e incluso hasta puede que mueran.
Because the 7 first days, your body will have to readjust and change, and the divine power will help to change, you understand? But if you interfere with it, you know, not adhering to the rule, then it's a trouble. Your body will just suddenly want to change in that direction, and then you break it, you know, like a car, you know, you break the sway so quick, it will break down and give you trouble, huh?
Porque durante los primeros días el cuerpo se ajusta y cambia, entonces el poder divino les ayudará a lograr esa transición. Pero entonces si ustedes rompen las reglas, el cuerpo se rompe, se
Yes, there are many rules and it's different from each person, huh?
Hay muchas reglas y es diferente para cada persona.
Yeah, but also different because of karmic background as well.
También es diferente debido a los antecedentes kármicos.
Even if you have the karmic background, it's not your job like to be breatharian in this lifetime, but if you meditate well, you are on high level, you can.
Incluso si ustedes tienen un antecedente karmático, no es que sea tu obligación ser respiracionista, pero si meditas bien y eres de alto nivel, puedes hacerlo.
Some people go through 3 weeks process, but they go back to eat again.
Algunas personas atraviesan el proceso de 3 semanas, pero vuelven a comer.
Immediately after, or a few months later, a few weeks later, or a few years later.
Inmediatamente después, o unas cuantas semanas después, o unos cuantos años después.
If they can go through the 3 weeks, and then after a while, they have a lot of benefit, ¿no? Their sickness are gone, and things like that. But if they start eating again, then all their trouble come back.
Si atraviesan el proceso de 3 semanas, se les tendrán muchos beneficios. Por ejemplo, se les irán todas las enfermedades. Pero si vuelven a comer, todos los problemas volverán.
Yeah, whatever benefit you gain, be lost.
Cualquier beneficio que hayan ganado se perderá.
Yeah, okay. Even if you follow the rules, yeah, exactly, ABC, you still have many side effects, you know, during the process. Like headache, you know, a stomach problem, a kidney problem, liver pain, or pain different parts of the body, or pain psychologically, because during that time you are more sensitive and your body is cleansing and trying to get rid of all the toxin in your body. And that will cause a lot of pain.
porque incluso si atraviesan el proceso de 3 semanas y tienen los beneficios, también tendrán muchos efectos colaterales como dolor de cabeza, dolor de riñones, dolor de páncreas, tendrán dolores en muchas otras partes porque el cuerpo está tratando de limpiar todas las toxinas que hay.
So it's better you have an expert to guide you. I don't have time for all this, okay?
Así que es mejor que tengan a un experto que los guíe, pero yo no tengo tiempo para todo esto.
What I'm telling you now is just a general rules of the breatharian, but it's not a instruction, eh?
Lo que les digo ahora es una guía general para el respiracionismo, pero no es ninguna enseñanza, ninguna instrucción.
And then it could also happen that you could not even walk around.
Puede ser incluso que sea el caso que ni siquiera puedan caminar.
And you have to lay down a lot.
Y tengan que estar recostados mucho.
Sometimes you couldn't get up.
Algunas veces no pueden levantarse.
Sometimes you might fall on the floor just by walking.
Algunas veces puede que se caigan en el piso al caminar.
And then your soul left the body and you just fell down like that. Yeah.
Y entonces su alma levanta el cuerpo, pero ustedes se caen de ese modo.
So you might have trouble.
Así que puede ser que tenga problemas.
Yeah, most people they go through the 3 weeks they need a partner to help them all the time, watching all the time.
La mayoría de la gente que atraviesa el proceso de 3 semanas tiene un compañero que los está vigilando todo el tiempo.
But the divine power is watching over you and working, help to help you, pero help your body adjust as well.
Pero el poder divino también los está cuidando y está ayudando a que su cuerpo se ajuste.
Yeah. But always. You need a person next to you, yeah, and a person who has experience in this also to help you.
Pero siempre es necesario tener una persona a nuestro lado y sobre todo una persona que tenga experiencia para ayudarnos.
Yeah, either in a group or personally. Yeah.
Ya sea en el grupo o personalmente.
Okay. Already your soul want to leave the body, huh? Listening to all that. Okay, it's up to you, eh? To want to be breatharian or eat without breathing. We are not breatharian, we're eating non-stop. We don't even have time to breathe.
Así que depende de ustedes si son respiracionistas o no, pero ya les he dicho que no somos respiracionistas, que no, ni siquiera respiramos porque comemos tanto que no tenemos tiempo ni de respirar.
No time to breathe.
No hay ni tiempo de respirar.
Hard to breathe, you know. Oh, eating too much.
Es difícil de respirar cuando comemos tanto.
And even when you try all that, and you even bear all that, still it's not guaranteed that you're going to stay on a breatharian course because maybe your body just gets weaker and weaker and you're losing more and more weight all the time until you had to stop.
E incluso si han atravesado ese proceso y han tenido éxito, nada garantiza que sigan en ese camino porque puede ser que pierdan mucho peso, que cada vez se debiliten más hasta que tengan que detenerlo.
Yes. And not everybody like that, of course. There are successful stories all the time, like in everything else.
No todo el tiempo es así. Por supuesto, hay historias de éxito como en todo lo demás.
And some people, even breatharians, still need to go back to eat for a while or a little bit just to keep the balance of the body, the weight.
Y algunos respiracionistas incluso tienen que volver a comer un poquito para mantener el balance del peso.
So it's not like free meal, huh?
Así que no es como una comida gratuita.
Needs a lot of work. And even after, for example, okay, you've been breatharian for many months already or many years already, you still have the desire for food that will come back sometime very strong.
Y aunque así hayas sido respiracionista por algunos años, por algún tiempo, siempre tendrás el deseo de comida muy fuerte.
And then if you eat a little bit, then a wow or something, and you feel very, very tired.
Y aún así, si comes algo ligero, incluso te sentirás muy, muy cansado.
Yeah, and feel sick even.
Y te enfermarás incluso.
And breatharian is not the cure for all sickness and all the problems in your life. No.
Y el respiracionismo no es la cura para todas las enfermedades y todos los problemas de tu vida.
So it's good to know that you don't expect too much. And you know how much you have to work to continue.
Así que es bueno que no tengas muchas expectativas y que sepas que tienes que trabajar duro para continuar.
Yes. If you want to try, Why not, hey? Yeah, but have to know a lot of things in advance.
Si lo quieres intentar, ¿por qué no? Pero tienes que saber muchas cosas por adelantado.
Still want to be breatharian?
¿Todavía quieres ser respiracionista?
No, porque nos vamos a juntar y vamos a hacer...
Now, Master, because instead of having dinner, we're going to gather together and breathe.
Okay. There are many people who teach breatharian nowadays. So easy to learn it, you know? Not like in old time, it's like a mystery or something. Nowadays, you see, I let you see all the breatharian people on there. You know they're still alive. Yes, and they give you their advice, their experience, and their thought about it, and even their guidance if you want. You see what I mean? Just fly to France or Germany, find a guru and do it. And then we see whether we still can have dinner or not, whether you can sustain your breatharian when the cooks is around. Oh, she's very strong. She loves to cook so much. We have to fire her one day. It's simple, you know. I can't believe it. Always some excuses to cook, you know. Always some excuse. I give up. I give up. I want peace in the family. I can't just keep telling people what to do. So, you know, like the king who has to drink also the stuff to be crazy like the rest of his country. Yeah. Otherwise, he'd be too lonely. No? Mm. It's doable, you know. First, we can start with simple food, you know. Like, okay, some bread and banana, you know. That's good enough, really. Yeah? Or if you don't like, you can bring your own food. Hmm? Yeah, something like that. Just stop cooking too much. I tell the cook, well, she always have good excuses, you know. And then even if she doesn't, she just cooks. Yeah, it's incredible. Some people love to cook, you know? Mm. Sleep in the sun. There's a balcony, there's garden. You can go out and snore your day away. Nobody say nada, huh? Sometimes I had to work all night also, not only you. So do it when you have to. Sleep when you can, but work when you have to, okay? Right. You go take some chocolate home for your grandchildren. And some chocolate. Box outside. Pick some, okay? And some candy, yeah, out there. It's a little tight, but it's your house now, so you can sleep in the balcony, sleep in the living room, who cares? See what I mean? Yeah, all right. Okay. And if we have more room, then we can spread out. If not, who cares, huh? I know you don't sleep anyway, right? You just sit and snore, right? There you have balcony. Plenty of sun all day. See? Beautiful. Here, go.
Dây thân ái lang dòng muôn nhà, tuy cách xa nhưng tim không xa. Vui tươi ta biết trong lòng nhớ lòng, ta hát cho không gian đơm hoa. Đường tuy xa nhưng tình không xa, đứng bước theo hương thơm nhà lưới truyền. Dù cách xa ngàn dặm những gần, đang các ta chia tay đừng buồn. Đây thân ái lang dòng muôn nhà, tuy cách xa nhưng tim không xa. đường tuy xa nhưng tình bao la, dẫn bước theo hương thơm nhà lửa truyền, dù cách xa ngàn dặm nhưng gần, càng tới ta chia tay đừng buồn, dày thân ái làng dòng muôn nhà, tuy cách xa nhưng tim không xa, đường tuy xa nhưng tình bao la, dẫn bước theo hương thơm nhà lửa truyền, dù cách xa ngàn dặm nhưng gần, càng tới ta chia tay đừng buồn.
À, em bé Trần Trầu à? Ok.
Vàng trên cánh đồng khi chiều hương ánh dương, trẻ thơ lớn dậy giữ quê giữ vườn, đời vui thái bình cây lúa trổ bông.
So well that if we don't have money, we can go out and sing and earn some money. No, I think the way we sing, if they don't give us tomatoes, it's already very good.
Creo que del modo que cantamos, si no tenemos dinero, podemos salir a la calle a cantar, aunque del modo que cantamos no creo que nos den mucho dinero. Nos aventaría el tomate.
Từng núi giang tây nổi lại biển xa, ta đi vòng tay lớn mãi để núi sơn hà. Mặt đất bao la anh em ta về, gặp nhau mừng như bão cát quay cuồng trời rộng. Vòng tay ta nắm nối liền một vòng Việt Nam.
Anh không cấm nổi liền một vòng Việt Nam.
Muốn gì nữa?
Vườn rau xanh ngát một màu, có bà mẹ quê nương nấu, mẹ quê vất vả trăm chiều, nuôi đàn gà con chắc chiều.
I told you, the way you sing, we have tomatoes. It's not enough money to buy cookies.
No habría suficiente dinero para comprar galletas.
Gracias, maestra.
Gracias. A usted.
Te amo.
A ley, a ti.
A ti, a ti, a ti.
làng tên Láng Dù. Em đi qua chiến đỏ à, sao em đành rồi. Tôi xin làm quán đời đừng chân em ghé chơi. Tôi xin làm đá cội và lan theo gió thải. Em đi qua chốn này, ôi à sao em đành vội. Tôi xin làm đá cội, từng chân em ghé chơi. Dằm những gần đáng sẽ có chia tay đừng buồn.
Tay và tay lan dọc muôn nhà. Đi khắp xa những tiếng phong xa. Người ta biết trong lòng nhớ lòng. Ta qua không gian đơm hoa. Đường đi xa những tình bao la. Đường bước theo hương thơm nhà trường.
Chìm sâu bờ lúa thương nhau, ôi những nẻo đường về đâu? Ôi ta đắp đường làng xa, nhân ai đi chợ quên về nhà? Ôi con đường về thôn vui quá.
Con đường về thôi.
rồi.
Ta bước trên đời cao, xong em anh chẳng soi lối vào những nẻo đường gặp gỡ duyên nhau. Yêu là yêu là yêu không bờ bến rồi. Chìm sâu bờ lúa thương nhau ơi những nẻo đường về đâu, những nẻo đường Việt Nam suốt từ Cà Mau thẳng tới Nam Quan ơi những nẻo đường Việt Nam.
Gracias.